Your hair? You need it?
No, I don't need this anymore, Matt. It is factory new, though.
It is factory new.
From what I can see.
Hashtag,
broken, of course.
No, hashtag Henry's G's in the chat for your chance to win it in a giveaway.
Henry's G's in the chat will give this away. It's a flip knife factory new comb edition.
Dust2, compLexity, TSM, both abysmal on the T side in the first map. This one favors itself to a little bit more puggy style. Maybe Sick can get things rolling with his individualism on this map, but there definitely has to be improvement from both sides.
It was a T side on both sides. Obviously, Mirage has a very specific way to play it. If you want to learn it, go on YNK's YouTube channel. He'll tell you all about it, how you should approach your defaults and stuff. There wasn't any of that stuff going forward there.
Did
on
he
Mirage.
Pay you?
No, actually. This is actually a really decent video if you want to actually know how the basics of the map work.
It's the one where you use a stat helix?
Yes. It's actually, yeah.
Okay.
That's what you should be doing, guys. But anyway, it's going to be Dust2, like you said, a much more easier play style. We're going to be getting into the pistol here. And it's going to be TSM on the CT side, compLexity on the terrace. We'll have a look at the buys coming in. It's going to be three sets of armor, a couple of flashbangs, compLexity going in fast, a little B rush here, all five players committed. And it's going to be a little bit troublesome for the terrorist. As you can see, two teams are going to kill the pack. There it is.
Well, it's going to be responded, though, because Android and Daphne's going to kill back. And that's going to cover up the doorway, try and get a shot through, but it's going to be Android again. And now they can try and plant the bomb down. He's a little bit hesitant to do so, despite having the man advantage, because no one's covering off the inside crack of the doorway. Which means he couldn't go for default, because they would have had a clear line of sight toward him. Zemphis in toward window, Android jumping to spot him still. It's already a 2K, make it a 3! That's a pretty sexy shot. And Whitmer, he manages to close it out.
I thought you said we weren't saying sexy anymore.
It was sexy, though, yeah. And you're right, I need to stop, but... I like sexy time.
Erotic shot, maybe?
That might be a little far.
Well, then, it was a nice round of compLexity. Very simple, of course. Straight up B-rush. When you have a decent spawn, it's not the worst idea in the world, for sure. compLexity, go in there, decent flashbangs of the CTs. Towards that car area. Managed to get the first couple of frags, but quickly responded. It looks like another B-rush coming in straight away, Matt. But it's the B-stack from the CTs. This could be a nightmare. It's surreal going in first with the MAC-10. Gets the first one towards six, but no frags coming in now for the CTs. No facing yet. It's going to be secured by death. He gets one. It seems to, you know. But it's still, they recover. It's fine. It's all good. B-rush on the end.
In the hood.
I would say it's not advised, especially when you know you're going against force by that. The full B-stack from TSM as well could have been a nightmare. But it works, so you can't really argue with the result sometimes, Matt. I would have given a nice lecture about it, but they've won the round, so it's redundant. You know, I can't justify calling people out when it's...
Please, Twist, just get one for me.
16 years old, of course, Twist. The new boy in the scene. Very impressive, very skilled.
A traitor to Canada, just like FNS and Semphis. Perhaps he deserves it. Oh, deserves to pay for his sins. Oh, okay. He's got two. Android gets Twist back, but that was what I wanted.
Yeah, it sounded like it. Jeez. Okay. 2-0, compLexity. Maybe they've got the B-rush again. Let's go for it once more.
I need wine.
Third and final attempt to do it. They could actually, I think they're going to go for it, you know. Let's do the B-rush again, guys. Yep. Let's go. Scout towards mid. And it's going to be the straight up B-rush. The thing is, the CTs are ready for this as well. You see, they don't want to cross just yet. They're going to come in delayed. But it looks like there's 3 towards CT spawn right now. B-rush does come in. And it's only going to be one player, actually. Semphis will be waiting for them. Here comes the rotation. The CTs are predicting this. But still comes in. Death takes it down with the MAC-10. FNS coming with that PT-50, though. Trying to make something happen here. The CTs do have position towards the back of the site. But just don't have the firepower to really do anything with it. And this could actually be something interesting. So the smoke, not going to amount to much, though. Automatically taken down. 4-on-1. Twist. Can you do the same thing again with that Desert Eagle?
Yes.
Yes.
I just want to yell again.
I don't. I feel like that would hurt my voice. I can feel it if I try to do it.
It's all right. One of us here has a stronger throat than the other. It's good for our relationship, if I'm honest. Twist trying to find the shot. Can't this time. Flashed up. Another player approaching from middle right now. The mid doors. It's pretty hard to find Sanks. In turn, shows him out of one tap with a P250.
3-0. And 3 B-rushes. We're going to the first gun run here, TSM. Obviously, Semphis did not force by as heavily as his teammates. He has the AWP. Naked, though, no armor. And they have not got a single kit either. So this could be kind of interesting. I think you're picking up that flicking of yours on the mic.
Yeah, I'm just practicing, you know?
So it might get kind of
annoying. I want to impress all the chicks.
Yes. No, I don't think there's any of them.
There was some here earlier. They were hanging out.
I missed that.
You did. Flash over, Twist blinded, but inside the pit, no one pushing. It's really insignificant, but I'm paid to talk, so that's why I'm telling you about it.
Well, the CT setup's going to be Twist towards the pit and FMS, as you said. And now we'll see if anything goes down. I'm not sure where Sempus is right now. I just see he's on the aim ramp. I can't really see the mini map too well, but yeah, he is. He's going to be aim ramp, backing up towards short. There he is. Thank you. I just got a B split coming in from Complexity. You can see the way they're set up right now. Two players towards lower B, two in the tunnels, and make it a third coming in as well. So this will be the B split coming in. They don't have any positional control of the map, so they're going to have to come into this at Whisper Point. And it's going to be the scouts. So Widmer, full on Jade in this round. And Sick, with a little play for now. I'm sure he'll pick up a couple of frags here, looking by his position. He's playing this quite nicely.
HP though, Sick, missing his shots. That's a huge mistake because Whitmer's able to take him down. FNS manages to get two, manages a third in through the smoke as well. And now he backs away, bomb dropped. Can't go inside of the site due to that smoke, but he needs to be weary of the fact that there is going to be a push from Def coming in at mid late. And this is even smarter because Sempus is going to go down. He lines it up, can't find the shot just yet on FNS. But he's done decent damage down to 44.
Ooh, that's a bit of a whiff and twist. Should have been putting out to bed a little bit earlier. And Death, he's going to be coming in to 12. Horrible display of aim here. I do give Death the benefit of the doubt. He is on a much higher ping than these guys, but still, he had an opportunity to get two frags here. That's a big round for TSM to win, but they do take a lot of damage in terms of the economy. You can see after three players being dropped, they are going to have a struggle to reinvest in this. I don't think they've recovered the AWP. So, bad times, because Whitman had a ton of cash. He only had the scout last round. So this could be a full reset coming in now for the CTs. But I would say at this point, they probably want to be looking for that first frag, try and do something a little bit different here. Two players towards short this time instead of long. So maybe trying to nade towards lower B, trying to do some early damage. So let's see all the players. Complexity slowing it right down, of course. Got the AWP, trying to take advantage of this situation.
Flash, twist, turns, not blinded, nearly gets a chance as a bunny hopping Death comes around the corner, but he will eventually find the shot. Good damage on the second peak as well, and now he's going to change it up because FNS comes in to try and do it as well, but Whitmer gets him with the AWP. Whitmer's got a second one on his Sempus as well. Bomb being swarmed on top of that catwalk, Sick with the frag. And they'll close it out, 3-2 now, TSM starting to pull this back in their favor, just one round of the difference. It could be similar to what we saw on Mirage.
That was the 3-0 for Complexity to kick things off, and then not winning a single. Well, they won one gun round after that. It was 11-4, wasn't it? But yeah, TSM, a big round for them. Like I said, that would have been a hard reset going into this one, but they managed to hold on and get the AWP back as well. It's going to be a pretty much full eco here for Complexity in PT50s, and block and smoke and flash and twist, anticipating this B rush once again. He'll be in lower B with the MB7. Going to have some real first, or is he? Death, maybe they're going to try and counter him at the same time. The first kill comes in, drops the bomb as well. Twist.
Whitmer with the shot back in turn, but automatic on the stairwell. Gonna find two again. Bomb dropped, finds it on Android. But Whitmer out the doorway with some style, with some steez. But it is FNS that gets him back down. So three, three. That's what I'm trying to say is the score. So you do this weird thing where you say three plays three, and then I think it's a situational, and then I start messing with my mind. It's all your fault, is what I'm trying to say.
I thought it might be.
Yeah.
3-3. Complexity, I'm going to be backing towards the buy though. Android with the AWP this time, which is interesting. Obviously, we associate the AWP with Whitmer. So let's see how they decide to approach this round. But TSM are three rounds in a row here. Molotoving towards the long doors. I'm going to be there for now. It does give them more confidence to cross to the pit and move there.
So trying to set for a default this time, with a little bit more of an early presence toward long. That does serve to bring a second player down from the CT's positioning. It weakens up that catwalk stance, but they haven't done anything to try and take advantage of either of those situations. Just say, oh, his foot was spotted.
Sempus does spot a couple of players towards mid, but it's difficult to give a serious read from that information. They're not sure whether they're going towards short, maybe they're moving towards lower B. He could get a kill here, though. It's a real and a dangerous position. If Sempus had faced the gap once again, he would have got the kill there, but the smoke coming up towards CT spawn now. It's looking like they won't commit towards the mid push. They're going to be going towards short, hoping that Sempus would wait on the other side. It's going to be an A play. They could potentially execute this. They have three smokes remaining, so the standard execute, smoking on the catwalk towards CT spawn, flashing over, and hoping you can get that next pick. But they have got the AWP on Whitmer, so maybe trying to slow it down. Taking out of the round for a bit, it's going to be that smoke delaying them. This is when you normally say, okay, we probably want to go back to mid now. The time's ticking away. By the time that smoke dissipates, we won't really have time to actually get to the side properly. So that's what they will be doing. Back towards mid, and the B-split will be coming in.
Automatic stuck inside of this machine. With the blades spinning on either side, it could be a counter-terrorist milkshake when this is all done. Automatic does get one, though, drops the bomb. But there it is, the two terrorists entering through, Android coming in from the tunnel, and the power of Whitmer.
Too strong.
Whitmer power. Surreal, good shot on Decemphis, and finally Complexity picking up a round on a T-side with guns before they lose 11.
CT's now two other player towards T-spawn, and going to hang in lower B as well. It's Evan-S. He's on his screen right now. I'm sure he's just going to try and get his AWP and get the hell out of there because it's not worth trying to go for this round. Obviously, TSM did win four rounds in a row, but it's Complexity bouncing back here on round number seven. Like we said, they were going towards A, and I thought that's what they wanted to do. Whitmer's going to go for the pick, but that smoke actually funneled them back towards middle. They managed to get the kills and went towards the site. Finding one kill there, he's done death, but it wasn't enough to hold them off. Complexity now, look at the money. It's still pretty strong for the CDs, considering they saved an AWP as well. They should be absolutely fine for a buy here. Have a look. AWP, M4s, maybe Automatic could drop a Famous and limit himself in terms of the utility. I think that's what they've done. There it is. So double AWP setup this time, Matt. What do you think about that one?
I think that if you put those two AWPs together and shoot a laser, and they should find a way to craft inside of their spawn.
Rush.
But they're going to need the correct materials. That involves getting the C4 out of the terrorist's hands inside of the B tunnels, which means it's stuck inside of the site. And Sick with the flash in is able to try and peek again, get in a better position on top of the platform. He's going to go for that headshot, but no, okay, he's not. I lied. I thought he was going to go for that headshot from the outside box, but flashed up. Unfortunately, he runs out of ammunition before he could spray down both because Android extremely low. Tempted by that AWP. Absolutely not.
Well, Sick was in decent movement there. He uses that smoke perfectly to get himself in a different position. They've got the bomb inside the B bomb site as well. So, now Complexity with a very difficult task here. Two players waiting in the bomb site, and they've got presence towards middle and CT spawn as well. So, the CT's strong armsing the situation. There is a minute remaining. They're hoping Android can get a pick with this AWP, but I would doubt that anyone will give him anything to work with here. It's a case of if anyone dies, the other CT faces, and that's. This is the perfect time. Twist gets the final frag. And TSM bounce back after losing that one gun round. It's going to be a full reset now for the terrorists. And you see, they're going to have $1,400 coming in. But Android and Whitmer and Sanks have enough to buy here. They could do three AKs and two Tech 9s. But it looks like they'll go for a more conservative approach. This Desert Eagle's in 50-50s.
You can't really be blamed.
Well, this double AWP setup's looking pretty strong for TSM right now. But still dead even there. 4-4.
Tried.
As long as he tried, I don't mind.
Pat on the back with a high ping for death. FNS gonna get up on top of the box inside of the CT spawn. Now Death is gonna lead the charge towards catwalk. Instead, good shot! FNS goes down, responded though by Sempis, who doesn't have the support play in position anymore, a rather open position, I have to say, for FNS, excuse me, to have been playing. Considering the situation that he was the rear gunner for Sempis, but he makes up for it. The three kills from him. Now plays to a 2v2. Bomb dropped over toward quad. And a very odd split out of all this, because Sanks is still trying to peek through CT. He hasn't done anything to advance his position, including go toward catwalk, because he wants that AWP to work. What it does do is mean that his teammate, who's out toward long, doesn't really have his support yet. Fortunately, 50 seconds, but they'll have to wait for this to get into position.
Bomb down in a tricky spot. The terrorist now, once again, low HP. It's going to be surreal. And Sanks splitting between long and shorter as well. Sanks with that AWP. You feel like Sempis has just got such a huge advantage in this situation. I'm not really sure what move Sanks can even do to get something out of this. He's going to throw. Is that an incendiary or a smoke to the AWP? But still, it was an incendiary. Does force Sempis out of position, so at least I have something to work with now. Could be an easy shot. Oh my god. As easy as I thought it would be. For some reason. Took the scope off and now Sanks is really dead. Surely dead. There it is. Final kill comes in. Okay. Eco now, surely. For Complexity. Oh, no, actually. Oh, they took the path by
they did, that's right. See, because they're playing it smart. They didn't want to trigger you, Henry G.
That's true. Well, I'm happy now. So they did.
Are you happy now?
Very happy. Round number 10. We'll see what the CT brings to the table. Back on that single AWP setup. Whitmer back with the AWP himself. It's going to be surreal. Using the wrong spawn here.
Actually, well. Are you really happy with who you are right now? For the 10 people that know Moneed in the chat, they'll be throwing up their hands. Surreal's got Twist. Sank does better than that. FNS goes down. And see, that's why you go for the partial buy, Henry, so you can get the execution with the AKs.
Well, they have got two kills at the start of the round. There's so much on the kill away, but Android quickly rectifies.
Why is Sick there? In that situation, when they've already lost two kills at long, why is he still
on the door? To be fair, like I said, Dust2 is a very reactive map, right? So he leads to the. Most teams, when they get kills along, they're not going to fully commit rush up long. They're going to fall back and try and split the bomb site. So if he's in the RB, he can potentially get the flanker player there, and he's trying to do something. Like, not give up the round completely at the start, but this is obviously over now. It's going to be automatic remaining up against four. Yeah, there is considerable damage that has been done, but it's not really going to do anything. So he gets the kill there. So we tie things up once again, 5-5. Just look at many lives of TSM. Oh, it's bad, Matt. It's real bad. Take the eco, boys.
Do it. So compLexity, who have won map one, sitting at 5-5 and a chance to find a sixth relatively easily on Dust2, map two. AWP for Surreal. Flash out Def, so allowing Whitmer to get in better position, but the rush out from long right now, this is three pistols and Whitmer's committed. He's forced in toward the dumpster, 9 HP, tries to Molotov it so he can get back across, but he's going to need the help of his teammates, and this forces them all to commit. This is a bit of a mistake. And Whitmer does get one back into FNS, but they lost Sanks. Thankfully, Android's there, and they know there's one more in this pit.
Whitmer is just facing.
Get out right now.
Get out. Like, he
wanted that was literally your chance out. There's still two players here.
It's fine, though. There's a decent black line. It was well.
You say it's fine. Oh, this is awful.
It's all fine, Matt. It's all good. 2-on-1 still. I like it. It's all good.
Look at this flank, though. Sick. Last alive, low HP onto Whitmer.
Sometimes
they're not moving away from this either. Look.
Sometimes you've got to make it.
They're just chilling.
That's all right. They know he's going to come and get some weapons, right? That's his probably best port of call here. So sit up. And oh, God, this is horrible. That's actually all right from compLexity. That's actually a decent call, right? They don't need to rush. There's plenty of time on
that's
the board.
That's true. I'll give you that. But I was just saying, look, it's my job to make it sound like it's exciting.
Yeah, like they're saying, right, he's probably going to come on and get these guns. He's assuming we've run away. So it's a decent call, like a horrible start to the round, of course. But comes down to the 2-on-1. compLexity do win it. It's still decent cash on Surreal. He's got 8k. And the rest of the guys should be good for another round as well. We'll see. Oh, it's double eco. So TSM now going to be back onto 5-7s and CZ. So compLexity have done themselves a massive favour winning the last round. Could be an absolute horror show if they hadn't. They should go 7-5 here. But so you can see how the terrorist side is a lot looser than Dust2. You can rely on the spawns a lot heavier. You can just go, okay, B rush. Oh, let's go for it. Oh, we've got a long spawn. Let's try and get long control. And there are options in that sense. You don't need to have the drill tactics. It's only when you're going for a standard, when you're pushing the CTs back, then you go for the execute. That's when you kind of need the set pieces ready to go. But still very simple in terms of execution for those.
Four to ward long, it's going to be given for free with these pistols at long range.
I've got the long control. This is how you should be approaching an anti game. If you are going to commit to something like long, all five players stick together. You have one in front of the back, Santin first. He gets the headshot on towards FNS. And now the CTs don't really have much to work with. Decent smokes to lock them out of the site. Bomb gets planted. There's no kits in the CTs, obviously. This round is done. They've played this very nicely indeed. Nothing given away. And now anything for 100 is not worth it. Don't give anything away at this point. Just keep your AKs, boys. Yeah, all you'd be doing is potentially risking your death and costing yourself cash. There's nothing to be gained. Apart from $300, maybe. That's it.
Just trying to find the shot.
Sank still wants it.
I know, they want to give away a gun. Why not?
Let's see what he decides to do.
It's just an AK.
He's falling back.
That was outrageous. They get one gun down for their efforts, but I don't know if you call that a good effort or a bad one.
From both sides, I guess.
7-5, yep. 7-5 now, compLexity with a two-round lead. AWP back into the hands of Whitmer.
And Sempis.
Obviously, they didn't have to rebuy. It was Android that had to rebuy, but it's Sempis that's going to pick it up.
After two partial buy, or two, I guess two ecos almost. It's actually a pretty weak buy from TSM. No armor on Sempis, no kits purchase, or automatic has one now. But a lack of utility as well. This is going to be another struggle for them. The dying sectors of this first half. The long control coming in once more. Surreal leaving the charge. A decent smokes there, take away the CT vision. They've actually isolated. Who's that in the pit? It's going to be Twist. So he's having a real tough time. He's got no backup as well. So the terrorists can take advantage of the situation is make sure they refrag. It doesn't have to kill him clean. Just make sure they have players facing him at the same time. This could be really advantageous for them.
Skin him like a rat.
All we have to do is face at the same time, boys.
Smoke's gonna make that hard, though.
Yeah.
It's deep, though. I think Death can see. I can't see through that. No, I lied. Okay.
Well, the opportunity they had is gonna be eradicated now, but they do have a player still towards blue bin, so hopefully gonna keep him there, listening out for the footsteps, the rotations. He could gather himself a free kill, potentially. Well, like I said, we know that you can see the feet in that position, though, so let's see whether Surreal will be discovered. A-split coming in, so Surreal won't make his move until they're literally like planting, until they're getting kills. He'll just be sitting there as long as possible. There we go. Perfect.
That works.
Yep. That's what he wanted.
FNS gonna walk back up, though, from CT. Still has Sempus out at long right now with the AWP. Good shot, finds the head of Android, but Sempus has to commit to that long position because of Surreal sitting there and taking down his teammate. And therefore, the AWP can't come back in to cover off the ramp, to cover off the A platform even more still. This automatic is going to take down Sanks, though. FNS has to fade away. They'll give up the site for the plant and play the retake with two. A kit only in the hands of Otto. And black screens are my favorite.
Automatic is dead. That's a win as well, the AWP, but he's not down towards long. A decent farm for him as well, so this could get interesting. Surreal, isn't it? FNS gets the first kill. I think it was a jumping shot as well. Ooh. He could do some big work here, but that's not going to be enough. Automatic now, low HP, decides to opt out of the situation.
What's his ping right now, I wonder, Def?
Still be 126, I guess. Why would it change?
Just curious, you know, in case things suddenly transported into another dimension.
The Atlantic Ocean got slightly smaller.
Actually, the Atlantic Ocean's the one that's spreading. It would be the Pacific that got smaller, Henry.
Anyway, can we press the tab then? Let's have a look, for Matt's sake.
Let's do it. Yanko.
It might have fallen asleep, you know.
Yeah, it's 100%. Hey, it's 126, you're right. It's still the same.
5 to 10 obviously is struggling, but they're still winning rounds. 4 in a row now, 4 complexity. They've won the half. And the money's still pretty bad for TSM. They will be forcing into this, though. This could cost them. We're going to the next round of $3,400, of course. They're on maximum loss bonus pretty much now after this. But let's see if they can do anything with this famous UMP scout and the AK. They managed to stay last. Pushing off towards short. Obviously, they need to try and make something happen with these lesser weapons, try and have some sort of surprise element. But Complexity are waiting for this. They are ready. Whether they can hit the shots is another matter. They were waiting for it, but it's FNS pushing up, gets the first two kills with the Famous, and like I said, Complexity seemed like they were ready for that situation, just get completely wrecked by the lesser weapons. FNS continuing his charge here, 3 kills for him.
Why not? 8 to 5, gonna be 8 to 6. Android, X23, gets 1.
That's such a weird name.
Stop asking questions I cannot answer.
It's more of a rhetorical question.
Why is the sky blue?
That's not the same sort of question.
Why is the sky blue?
Well, I don't know. There's a scientific reason behind it, isn't
it? It reflects the ocean, Henry. Everyone knows that.
No, definitely that's not the reason.
Why is the ocean blue?
What do you mean? This is
because it reflects
water.
The sky.
Oh, God. Anyway, we're going to round number 15. Yes, Sam, who were on the back foot in terms of the economy, do bounce back. With that aggressive push, Sempus looking lower B now. Should get his kill towards Sanx as well. He's done for closing up B as well. Great aggressive play here. That's going to funnel the terrorists towards long. They have to act fast now. They've lost the entirety of the map. They're going to be challenged by Twister as well. Twister doesn't need to face this. That's the thing. He can like maybe go for a quick shoulder peek, get the information. Does not need to commit. Or sick, takes down Surreal.
For the record, the sky is blue because of the atmospheric refraction from the light. It has to do with the Kelvin scale. Whitmer's going to fire. Does hit the shot on Sempus. Looked like he was a little bit wide, but does just collect the shoulder. The Achilles heel. The Achilles shoulder. Sempus shoulder. Wish gonna pop back out, finds two, though. That stops the bomb. It sprays continuously until he finds Android. 8-7 at half. Anyone's game completely, and different map, no less, but Complexity much better this time on their T side.
Yeah, they had some decent fundamentals out. Utilizing the spawns quite a lot. They win the pistol once again. So they did 3 B rushes in a row to open it up. So you can see. Quite a loose play style in terms of other maps. You can get away with that sort of stuff. And they're using the spawns for long as well. Trying to get that long control can be one of the most valuable parts of the map. Once you get that, it means you can push the CDs back to the site, go into an A split, force them to go for some aggression towards B tunnels perhaps, potentially. So it's a much easier map to play in terms of like raw tactics. You can rely on your star players to step up and find your kills and win your rounds single-handedly. So Def obviously was struggling. I think he finished on like 5 for 10 or something. He's one of the stronger fraggers on the team.
But I mean, the ping doesn't definitely
help. That's the point I'm making. Yeah. So like, they're missing.
He did have the 3v2 retake where he tagged up FNS to put him into red HP from 45 and then killed the second minute. Don't hit the grenade with the switch comb.
I just want to see whether you can do the actual, when you press inspect in game. So what is that?
You're going to cut yourself. That is atrocious. What are you doing?
You okay?
That's all right. Yeah, it's just this is all he does.
No, he does all this stuff.
I like that. Doesn't he spin it for once? Yeah. We were talking about this. He just does like the...
You've been practicing.
What do you mean? I'm good. It's my. I take this to the bar with me and I just go, hey, baby, I'm going to shank you later.
Well then, okay. Well, what can you say about that one? We will be getting to the second half here. I think the freeze time has been canceled at this point. Oh, no, maybe not. But yeah, it's very dead even, like you said. It is going to be complexity winning the half just about. But some decent reactions there from TSM. We were missing that in Mirage. People weren't...
To be fair, I think he just does it with like one finger because that way he can rotate it quicker. I think...
Who does that belong to, by the way? Where did it come from?
Do you know what the funny thing is? The guy with the least amount of hair of all of us owns it.
Who?
James.
Oh, really?
Yeah. He just likes props.
Fair enough. I guess it's kind of cool.
It's made by Benchaid.
Second half begins.
He got it shipped from Finland. Why would Of course Finland would have this.
Of course. Second half begins. You heard the bell. TSM now on the terror side. They've gone for a much more tactical approach in terms of the buy so far. Two smokes and a Molotov as well. That would be probably for a post-plant situation. Sang's going towards middle. He gets absolutely destroyed by the Glock from T-spawn. And now he needs to try and fall back here. Very careful. He's, I don't know why he's still facing, but he's going for it. Going to be watching the terrorists and hearing them go towards short, and it's going to be six leading the charge here. Death to challenge him first, but he's got that low sense of chance of making it happen. But Surreal gets a lovely shot there with the USP, takes down Sick, FNS. He gets a shot towards Death, and now they are kind of pinched towards the bombsite here. Sank taking out FNS in the turn.
Otto. Going to run back, try and play this from catwalk. One to stay at quad by default, that's Semphis. Go for a late peek when they're not covered off from both angles, and Otto waiting for flashes to come over has his back turned. He's not sure when to peek again. And when he does, he's greeted by Whitmer, who fights forward to try and find Semphis, but the shot comes in from Taz to save him. This is where the crossfire prevails. And once again, Twist, excuse me, not Taz, is able to pick up another double kill, but he is gone, and it's a great shot. They were thinking about knifing even Surreal. Default knife, they don't have this. Thanks. Ooh, they do. Oh my god, that's
what?
Close.
I didn't have the sound in my ear.
I do, and I wasn't even sure. Default knife, I was about to call him a noob, but it was 0.3 seconds. What a play.
Wowzers. Is that a word to say?
Yeah. Henry G would say that.
Oh, wow. That was a great round. Complexity. Even though TSM had full control of that situation, the crossfire set up, they had the man disadvantaged, but great crossfires. And it comes down to the 0 second defuse. So, Complexity, once again, in this series, they've won all four pistol rounds back. That is pretty crazy. So surely going to be the victors here, but we'll see how this one goes down. They are going to be 9-7 up. No force buy from TSM, of course. They'll be buying up in the third with the AK. So just some PT-50s and Deagles here to try and help them get the bomb down. If they do that again, that could be very beneficial to them going forward into that round. Surreal waiting on the site. We've got Whitmer here in towards the car. He'll be trying to listen out for footsteps, trying to cause a crossfire. It probably should be the other way around in terms of this setup, but let's see what he can do. I'd like, if they come towards short, I'd rather have the MP7 on the side that's still being weaving.
Play, continue spraying, why not? Whitmer again with a double. But Automatic and Twist have made it at least a decent situation in not only finding the frag, the refrag onto him, excuse me, at the car, but Twist coming in from catwalk, that picks up an M4. And look at the damage he's done. Over the top, he'll find Death. And suddenly it's down to the 1v1. Twist goes to the Deagle instead of the M4. He doesn't want to reload, but he lands it up. That was very well controlled, very relaxed and comforting. From the young man from Canada.
Strange approach to Complexity. Bomb hadn't even been planted at that point. They're just rushing and panicking when they see the bomb thrown onto the site. It was very nice and Twist, I have to say, but still, Complexity could have calmed down a lot more. They had a player coming from short as well. Just waiting to see the spawn, waiting for your teammates to be there. That's how Counter-Strike works, guys. You got to make sure you eradicate all these possible points of error. And they got a bit too excited and saw the bomb cross. Don't implant, whatever you do. And sometimes I've said, don't implant and make sure you give yourself the guarantee of winning the round. That player coming towards short, he would have been with them. He wouldn't have had control of two players in towards city spawn. And I could go on about that situation all night long, but it'd be very boring. But so it's going to be 9-8 TSM winning I don't know, I'd say they didn't really deserve, they didn't really have anything for that. Very special situation. Orbs, AKs, M4s, all down.
Ooh, nearly caught him on the exchange there as Whitmer had to run from the flames. Death. Death, whatever you want to call it. Automatic, dead. Death wants more, but he falls to Sempus. And the AWP is fighting forward still. It's FNS to back him up because they tried to push through and catch him off on the reload, but it is FNS instead. It's getting surreal. It's going to look good for the rifles now. Twist spots up at least one more. Again, just trying to tap. Very disciplined with the trigger, but has to run and get back into the site. 28 HP, and now he's got the boxes to dart and dance behind.
Should be almost guaranteed round at this point, but they are just waiting to get the bomb plant. This is fine, though. You don't have to rush plants. Make sure you give yourself a 100% chance of getting the bomb. Three players, are very low, so I just want to make sure they're pushing them back towards short CTs, just with USPs and PT50s. Don't really have much to work with, just hoping they can get a chance headshot on towards Twist here. But I don't think they'll get any. Twist through the barrel there. Gonna take on the Sanks. And now he can fall back. It's a platform plant, so don't really commit. But Twist, you can see he's in the zone. He wants to get his final kill. He wants to take the risk with M4 for no real reason, but you know what? I'm gonna be confident. I don't mind. Sick takes him down in the end. Android drops. And we go to number 19, the money. All the CTs still not balanced out here. So if they were to buy, it'd be an absolute shocker. I think they will just be taking a partial here. You see Whitmer, $4,900, so you definitely can get an alt next round. Potentially two if they wanted to.
Uh-huh.
We get into round number 19. Here we go. Decent spawn breath nest, as I said. Best two can be a spawn reliant map. Flash out. It can be very beneficial.
Ooh. Ooh. FNS with the refrag after the 1D. Sempus with the AWP just covering off across at middle. They are on either side of this, and they're trying to be a little bit clever. They make sure that the AK is not re-grabbable first and foremost, but they're wanting information, so it's going to be Android, I believe. Don't take that back. Sanks, excuse me, that's going to be pushing into the B tunnels. Have to do something out of this dirty situation that they find themselves in, but it's not like they're going to be able to do much with that push into the tunnels either, because they are going catwalk and long and A-split bomb crossing now. Bomb going to be planted within the next 7 seconds, and Sanks going to be dying in the next 13.
You think so?
11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. Oh, God damn it. Close. Close. He got damage done on 13 seconds. He died at 16, 17, 18, 19. Just die already. Jesus, thanks.
Still, strong part of the car so far. I think one of the most exciting moments we've had. 10-9. TSM do take the lead now. And you have to say, Complexity did throw that massive round away. That cost him almost three rounds here. We're going to number 20 now. And it's going to be the orb coming out for Wentman. They're not going for the double. Android coming in with M4 to finish things off. They have got a decent buy here, chance to get back into this. It really is going to come out for a while. I wouldn't be surprised if we saw it overtime again, Matt. Really wouldn't surprise me. It comes down to this. Three players in lower B, four TSM. I'd imagine they get flashed through middle from the top of mid. And I'll try and go for the pick here. There's the first smoke onto the left-hand side corner. It's going to be Sempus backing them up. Should just go straight towards catwalk here, so maybe he's working a pick, and we'll see one of those classic defaults of trying to push the AWP back, and that'll be Whitmer this time. Can he step up? Yeah, they're going to be setting up for a smoke take here.
That's not actually well placed, because Whitmer now has to play it for the quad. Looks for the drop instead, knows one's gone down. He's given up so much ground, they're going to be pretty much on top of him. Sick! There it is! AK in the face! And Twist going to plant the bomb now down for catwalk. Three CT players coming in from the spawn. One out toward long, just making sure there's no late push. And once they're in position, he should quickly turn back and start to approach for the retake. But he's actually not right now. Surreal just sitting down there. Now he's going to go once the flash comes in. Around the corner, halfway up the wall already. But look at the flank from Twist. It's well timed. He gets one. He only gets one. He actually goes down, but automatic is able to pick it up. Brilliantly done.
Yeah, very nice flanks there. If you can get in those sort of positions from mid doors as the CTs are going for their full retake, you can cause absolute chaos. And that was proven there. And it's going to be another eco coming in from compLexity. Can't really justify much more than some upgraded pistols here. CZs, Eagles, it seems, and TSM in a healthy lead here. And 11k on Sempus as well. They've got money for days. And change of pace if the CT's going to be boosting two players up towards short. We'll see what kind of, if they've got any grenades or not. They've got a smoke and a couple of flashes. Not really much I can do with these, but looking like a simple contact B play from TSM.
Android, Tinkle. Woo! Bye bye, Sempus.
They've got the bomb as well.
They do have the bomb as well. It's inside, well inside of the site. Death gonna try and get up on top of the boxes. Unfortunately, UK players can't jump, so doesn't get there. Automatic gets Whitmer in turn, and now they need to make sure they don't overcommit to this. They don't overface, and Sanks goes down. They have a chance to wrap back through the tunnels. They want it. They can easily split from middle. Good shot from Android. He's the last alive, though, and that gun is going to be so tempting right now. Just barely grabs the barrel. FNS is low, and he could do well to time this. Now, if FNS is observant, he'll realize that AK's gone missing, which means he must be close. They're both on red. Android falling away. Remember, no armor. Aim punch could be a very severe factor in this case. Goes back for the door. Nearly lines them both. Hits the shot on automatic and TSM. It's down to just FNS to find this bomb. It's near the empty corridor, which is now dropped and taken down as Android comes back through. Huge play. Four kills from him, two with the Deagle.
Android with four kills. TSM there going for that simple contact B play. But I said, as soon as they went to that first pick, they took a ton of damage. And it's kind of to fall apart as they're committed towards the site. And the Desert Eagle coming up massively for Android. And he picks up the AK and finishes things off in the 2-1. And that's a massive round for them to get back into this. Like I said, I'm very confident we're going into overtime here. It's very, very close in terms of back and forth and the money situations for both teams. But TSM going to be going in to Sempus all once again. I think they'll be retaking long. Bombs down towards that position. Some mid-control coming in as well. They're going to be uncontested for now. It's quite a passive hold from the CTs. And Sanks. Drops smoke and bait himself in. Flashbangs here. So, instead of allowing a mid split to come in and have to deal with tunnels and mid, they're trying to focus on that mid area. Overrun it, and Sick does return with a frag. Death pushing through mid doors here. Does know automatic is here. Wall is going to be big. Manages to hit the headshot there.
Yes.
4-on-3.
Yes. I do ponder the chance. Okay, so there it is. They're going to use the skybox, the lack thereof. Smart from Whitmer to play inside this. He can hit a shot and then Houdini back into it. Disappear at will. Maybe so. Whitmer's got two, almost a third. Chase it down. This ain't no monkey business. He's not monkeying around. 11-11, Henry. Make a wish.
Oh, I'm so sick of making a wish.
Yeah, I know. But, you know, it's the only thing you can
rely
on.
Every game goes to 11-11.
It's good. I need a lot of wishes.
At least we're casting American CS, so they even know what we're talking about when we say 11-11.
It's Canadian versus the UK. Oh. We've been over this.
Oh, yeah.
Why do you assume that's an American thing?
Because I've never heard of it.
So because you haven't heard of it, Henry hasn't heard of it.
Every other Brit I've mentioned it to, no idea.
So maybe it's just not a British thing. It doesn't mean it's an American thing.
Is it American
Do you think you count for the whole rest of the world in the UK?
Is it an American thing?
I don't think so.
Where is it from then?
It's probably like Japanese or something.
Probably. They famously say 11-11 in English.
Yes, they do. They love palindromic symbols. They told me.
Anyway. It's going to be a TSM force by here. Galil and a Desert Eagle into a twist. They've got a lack of utility as well. They'll be struggling this round. Sempus has the orb. It's going to come down to that man there, whether he can make something happen. Once again, going towards the A site. Four players towards the catwalk area. And there's one towards T spawn. He'll be the one getting those flanks towards CT once again, as we saw when they went for the execution. What they're going to hold him off with the flashbang, waiting for the flash to come himself before he faces once again. But should have a chance to get a kill here. Twist as well. Flurry of frags coming in right now, but it's still the man advantage towards compLexity. Android about to step up. Will he face towards middle? Trying to find the confidence for him. But it's not going to matter. Still a 2-on-1 in compLexity favor. The bomber is down towards the mid doors.
For the Night's Watch, automatic. It's going to grab.
Is that what it means? It wasn't the
We just, world. I don't know. We just agreed on that. I don't know what it actually is. Tim never wins.
That's what it was. You're right.
Automatic going to check off these corridors in the lower tunnels, but he's got someone staring him down. He's greeted by that someone. That someone is surreal. A mix between reality and something that is perceived not to be.
Indeed. That's really one thing about. The young Brits, let's get the final kill. And it's going to be 12-11 here. and a force buy coming from TSM. I didn't think they'd be doing this.
But they've gone. What did you think they were going to do?
I thought they'd potentially just get some upgraded pistols, like a pretty much full eco and try and build the cash up, but they're all like, can I have a look at the scoreboard very quickly, please?
No.
Very quickly. Actually, too late, too late. Keep going. Sick, that's the first kill. This kid's working out. Very fast B-split coming in here. It's going to be two CDs waiting for them, but a huge advantage. You see, Whitmer does have some vision. Gets one through the smoke. It's going to be Sanx stepping up with Android as well. Twist gets the kill to see that. Oh, doing some fantastic work here. And they hold on strong. Looked like a very successful round coming in from TSM. Good, fast strat. And now it's round number 25. compLexity can get in touching distance now, Matt, of series points. compLexity have been struggling in a lot of leagues recently. Whether they can actually find some wins here, have had some decent maps against NRG in the first night they casted, and unable to actually win any. But one mirage. And looking like they could take Dust2 as well. TSM once again, partial buy. They must be racking up that loss bonus at this point. As we enter round number 25. Are you ready?
Yes. Ask me one more time. Yes.
Yes.
Yeah, I think so. I think I can do this. All right.
Take it away.
All right. Semphis with... Oh, Deagle! All right. He hits the shot onto Death. I can't even mess around when he hits a shot like that. That was pretty nutty. Mid now weakened up. They can try and exploit the fact that they've thinned out the defense. He's obviously the swing player as well, as he was on the right side of mid. They're going to know that's one less on the A side. So here comes the smokes, the drop play. Whitmer going to be under threat and around the corner. These Tech-9s could be threatening. Whitmer hits a nice up close shot though. And now suddenly Surreal caught in the open, nearly gets pincered out, but Automatic can't close the kill. Bomb is still going to be planted, but Surreal above this one finds one more. And he's got the information on where they're trying to transfer to right now. It's Sick, the last alive.
Really solid play there from Surreal. He's going to be finding the last player here. Surely he gets the headshot as well. That's actually very strong from him. He gets three kills in the round and he is stuck between a very difficult situation.
Players rock in a hard place.
I was going to say
that. I know you were trying to avoid
it. It. Everyone says it. I was like, don't go there. It's something we always say too much. But yeah, like he was stuck between players coming from long and then forcing themselves with that smoke and crossover as well. But it looks like, what have we got? Pause.
Tactical pause. 56 seconds, apparently, was what the time was, we were told. I mean, this makes sense for TSM to call this right now. If compLexity win two more rounds, this series is done, dusted. That wasn't meant to be something. Look at that shot. Wasn't meant to be something about the map they're playing on. But it's over. That, you did you catch the handle or the blade?
The handle?
Oh, okay.
That, if this is a real knife, I'd have cut my own wrist by now.
You absolutely wrecked yourself.
We'll look good for that, Dan.
I knew this was a good idea to bring this in here because we would totally talk about Counter-Strike.
Now we've got a new properly, so we got...
Wait, on how to do this. Fire in the hole.
I thought I was going to break something.
And we're dead. See? You still suck at
actually,
that.
No, that makes it better.
Yeah, because you don't... You can't hold it down. You muzzle it. You have to... See? What are your thoughts from TSM? What can they do to make this better? Because obviously money's been an issue. That round, I really did think, if Whitmer hadn't hit the first shot from the player coming up from CT, I think they would have had it.
Yes, I agree. And they could have done it. But I think this pause is more to kind of stop the momentum, kind of to calm down a little bit. They're probably thinking, it's not so much the approach of the round is going horribly wrong, it's just that they're not winning.
Why
these
is that nade you're not exploding yet?
It's got a long defense on it.
Did James buy a dud?
Long take coming in here, change of pace here for sure, but it's Whitmer! Double frag with a Molotov, and it's Sick though, he does make it in the turn. It's going to be Whitmer getting his third of the round. He needs to get out of this situation, he's still being committed behind the smoke. He's probably going to die here, Matt. I'm not a big fan of this decision, but he's going to...
Oh, Semphis, okay. That was easy for Semphis. I was going to say Semphis is scoped up. If he had gone to the other side of the smoke, it might have been one of those stupid plays where it works out, but you're right, he had no business being there.
Like, he obviously committed at that point, but... I'd say just have the AWP up, hope for the best. Just running through your pistol isn't really a good amount to anything. 14-11 now. Semphis will be pushing up towards the crossover. Looking for the next pick. I think he'll get this as well. All day long. Yep, there it is. Semphis takes him down. Oh, he takes down Sam, I should say. But now, almost a guaranteed situation here. This would be an absolute nightmare for them to throw away.
Yeah, gifted.
But he is coming from long, Android.
You're gifted.
Bomb has been planted.
Certain areas I am, yeah.
Android, well played, well recovered. Gonna try and grab an AWP and change this, but unfortunately for him, it's planted at catwalk, which means no one needs to face this. And he's gonna stick to it. Likely just try and get a kill and keep it. Yeah, there. Mine, I keep for you. I give to you next round.
Is that what he talks like?
I have no idea what he talks like. I'm just entertaining myself. Because unfortunately, for the next 10 seconds, we don't have much to talk about, Henry.
Yeah, we do. It was a TSM. They lost the first two frags there to the Incendiary. Whitman found a third as well, but is Sick once again stepping up. He finds two frags, and Sempus with the AWP on the second soil. Scoping up, it wasn't any doubt in my mind he was going to miss those shots. He gets him back into this. And the money's still strong for the CTs, but that, like I said, once you have the long spawn, it's almost like the Hail Mary play. Just go in and see what you can do with it. They flashed over and lost the first two frag before, almost a guaranteed round for Complexity, but wasn't meant to be. Problem is, though, TSM now lost the accumulated bonus of five rounds. It's going to be reset to 1400 if they do lose this round. It potentially could cost them the game. Let's see how it goes down there. Very exciting. And we hit the final stage. This is going. This is rushing now. It's like, yeah, no, rush long. Okay, I would have rushed short, Kelly. Crazy. Play coming in. Chris getting the first two kills. Automatically gets one as well. Just keep rushing. That's all we've learned from this now. Forget how to actually do CS properly. Just rush.
Yeah, I mean, TSM post timeout looks like they could take full control of this game right now.
Just rush.
Well, rush isn't on this team anymore.
Was that a joke, Matthew?
I'm not really sure what it was. It was so bad.
Was it a sense of humor?
I don't really know anymore.
Didn't have any substance to it whatsoever.
They're hunting as well. They know the situation as best as we do. Sanks might get one here on to FNS. Easily done, but his teammate is going to come under threat, and he can't even rotate back in to help him because as soon as he does, he's going to be cut off by Sick. Peasy Lemons. EZPZ Lemon Squeeze It. I'm sorry, I forgot we're in Britain. There it is. They get Android as well. Worth it. At the price of one gun, bomb goes off. It's now a 1-point game in TSM with a great economy situation. They will be able to buy, but only. Actually, take that back. Sorry. I got confused because I saw Android's money, and I just assumed that they were all even, but apparently they've been making mistakes throughout the course of the half.
We've all made mistakes, Matthew, some more than others.
You're right. I'm really sorry about all those mistakes you've been making.
Me too. Round number 28. Here we go then. TSM, after two very audacious rounds of rushing long, rushing short, they are going to be forcing to pretty much full eco here. And first kill does get taken down by FNS. Android does find it in return. He can find the kill. FNS, one bullet required. He gets it. Surely that's not the way that TSM throw his game away. They are going to have two AKs to work with now, but the problem is terrorists have got the control of the A-bomb site. Making their way to it's a long plant as well. Should be an almost guaranteed situation at this point. Sempus can get towards long, and he can have his two teammates. Oh, it doesn't even matter. He's going for the aggressive face towards middle. Why not? Guaranteed in round. Sempus has been winning them a lot of these key rounds towards the latter stages. I feel like this is going to be overtime now. What do you think?
Yeah. Yeah, why not? We had a double OT game last time. I don't mean double OTs in two in a row. I mean two overtime
two
games
maps,
in a row, yeah. Last night, it actually did go the distance in all three. Don't forget, we still have Liquid CLG coming up after this.
That's the hot match of the night.
A barn burner. Twist gets death. And another one to TSM. And even less money now for Complexity. Overtime may not even be possible. To be completely honest, they'll be able to get what they can out of this. AWP as well for Whitmer. Death on the M4.
Can we jump on the Whitmer cam, please? I want to see what
that is. Is that what they actually technically is? He has his own camera.
That's what I.
Is he sponsored by GoPro?
I installed it on the server before.
It's GoPro?
Yeah. No, nothing interesting. I was hoping to get boosted up to short and try and do something interesting. Excuse me.
You?
Yes. My stomach still doesn't really know how to operate at these sort of times. I shouldn't be awake.
No, you shouldn't.
But
smell this cloth and let me know if it smells like chloroform.
Okay. Now it's looking like another fast approach. Here. TSM is throwing the defense out the window. It's going to be choosing an objective, and they seem to be going for it this time. Let's go, guys. Smoke was towards mid. Let's take short once again. Not rushing this time, but going to be going for the simple plays, probably similar sort of smokes we've seen before, and try and rely on the Sempus orb. CT's out, reacting to this. Three players towards the B side of the map. These operate quickly now. As they are going to be flashing into the B tunnels, going to spot no one's there, and now you need to start moving, lads. Let's go. Come on.
This is interesting because they're going to get so much read on this, so much information, so much map
it's
control.
Like, it's almost useless information at this point. You've got three players there. Like, if they commit towards A, what are you going to do with this?
But they're not necessarily going yet. The problem is now that Tempest hits a shot on Death, they are going to go, and they are not only that going to lose one of the very important men in that rat pack of... I don't know what, dogs. Rat cat of dogs coming from the stones. Sallex gets automatic
back. A pack
back
of dogs, home. Maybe.
And suddenly, listen, don't question my logic. It all makes sense in my head, and that is all that matters. It is a one-man advantage for Complexity trying to retake this site, though. Kits for both Whitmer and Droid. And when I say both, it usually implies two, but Sallex also has one. So the thrice of them. That is surreal. Gets the shot. This is good because now they can cross over, get toward that platform. Still planning for catwalk, though. Have to hold this open. Whitmer needs to hit it. Does do so. And Surreal can go forward. Checks out Quad quickly and finds it on the edge of the smoke. It's going to be map point first for Complexity. And keeping four alive is massive in this situation, given the money situation.
So what I meant by when I said it's almost useless information having three people enough to beat, the problem is as soon as Semper's got that first kill, I was assuming he was going to spot the last two of them and say, guys, just fully rush A at this point. We know they're on lower B. They're out of position. There's only going to be two towards A. That's why it makes sense if you have one person pushing up a B, because then he gets tons of info and he can tell his teammates, okay, guys, rotate towards A. You guys can actually get that. That's useful information. Having three and lower, it's normally, I'd say, a little bit useless. But, you know, it worked out that time. Complexity now one round away from taking this series, and TSM have got long control, though. The balls to refaces, though, it's going to be difficult for them. The flame goes on, it's going to get two there, surely. Takes down Wimmer, but Def answers back. He's done a ton of damage as well. They're trying to boost clumsily towards that blue bin. It's going to be three of them there, and it's going to be a missed shot from Sempest. That one had to hit. Automatic trying to do what he can. Takes down Surreal. This is going to come down right to the wire. Low HP, more sick, and altered. Automatic.
Sick. Trying to find the shot onto Def, who knows he's here now inside of this smoke. They commit to it, and he does manage to pick it up. So they've got them at advantage. Bomb down toward long, though, but still have to get toward the site. And that's going to be in the hands of Automatic with 10 HP. Android, first up the ramp. Smoke spotted. Oh, massive gap. It doesn't have his gun. They throw it. It's gifted. If he had a jump, he would have been by because the gun wasn't drawn. Now it's a 2v2, and Automatic with 10 HP had to distill himself from that cover behind the box because he had to go retrieve that bomb. The jump shot nearly does it. It just barely misses. Narrow margin at that, and they are going to stick the plant. Sallex playing from catwalk has to wait for it to favor him, but they flash out. Android with one Automatic can't do this. There's no way with 10 HP he can do this, or can he? No! Android hits it. Fennec from Canada. Complexity 2-0 over TSM, who, if they kept their Canadian flag, would have won the series. Victory bell.
Two times for two maps. That's what you have to do. You have to count how many maps they win. Anyway, Complexity do it.
Welcome back, YNK.
Hello. You missed some really great stuff. You're doing stuff with knives and jokes.
Was you like, how was your hair?
There was a rat pack of dogs at one point. Like, it was all sorts of stuff going on.
Yeah, I have dandruff. It's no big deal. I
stay away from it.
Complexity, with a player in the UK, have won 2-0. And they've won all pistols tonight as well. That's quite a big factor. I think there was, in terms of the gun rounds, there was like, it was pretty even, to be fair. And TSM, I'd say, almost had the edge, but winning both, all four gun rounds, pistol rounds tonight, it's going to have.
I had to think about that for a second, but yeah, they did.
Yeah.
The only thing is that in the second map, second half, they lost the second.
The ego,
They lose the ego. Of course, they do against no armor.
Yeah, that was.
They just decide to give control of Long and Cat. Play 2-1-2 setup for no reason. Yeah, but I felt that this map.
I like how you pull yourself.
Yeah,
back
I mean
there.
This map wasn't as, you know, weird, so let's call it like that, as Mirage was. But there were a couple of, again, crucial mistakes at crucial rounds that in the end decided the winner. Of course, losing both pistols again is never easy to recover from. But there was that one round where, are we calling him Android?
Yes.
Yes, okay, Fennec, Android.
Yeah, where Android got, I think, a quad kill, or he got a two kills with the Deagle, then picked up the AK.
A player
from TSM ran all the way in with the bomb. I mean, not by himself, his teammates were there, but they were like picking and prodding from the tunnels. He just ran in all the way. The bomb was dropped, and they were like, what do we do now? Instead of just committing, you need to commit at that point. And you could see, at, I think it was 14-13 round, I'm not really sure, when TSM just rushed catwalk with at least four players, and they got, Twist got great entry kills, but they went in as a unit, right? Through the smoke, who cares? Yeah. They had a read, they were probably going to be towards long, the CTs, I just try and get cat control. And even if the first player dies, there's the rest of the team to pick up the trade kills. And that was a great round, but a bunch of times, again, we saw similar to Mirage, people just, you know, waiting around.
You saw after their poor CSM, that's when they just thought, you know what, we're actually just screwing up all these defaults. Why don't we just say, we get decent spawn, let's rush long. they've got a decent forward versus rush short, and actually worked out. Actually, two rounds actually got them back into the wards of the game.
So nearly those, had the game. In
those
fact.
Kind of things that those can work sometimes. You can see how the CDs weren't expecting that whatsoever. They actually were boosting up onto the bomb site when they just rushed short, and they weren't ready for it whatsoever. And I always say that long is one of the most important parts of the map. If you can swarm it with the correct flashbangs and do good smokes to take away the CT vision, that can be a very effective way to win rounds. But yeah. They did that a couple of times, just threw away the defaults, and that's how they got back into it. But Complexity seemed too strong. Just in the end, they kind of pulled it off.
And Whitmer also had a pretty good game. I think he ended up on 27 kills. And we pointed out that they would need someone to step up significantly individually, because TSM is, this is one of the map, one of their favorite maps to play as well. You know, when you combine all of that, we also, they had another crazy close clutch round where they defused like in the really last.
Was that the pistol?
That was the CT pistol.
Yeah. It was a 0.3 second.
I mean, not only step up individually because it's one of TSM's better maps, but the fact that they were lacking in Def's frag power, Def's frag power being in the UK. So, I mean, that's a big.
He was bottom. And he's like one of the guys who's actually one of the best fraggers in that team.
Did you know that? So obviously he's having visa issues. That's why he's back in the UK. There was a petition going around you can sign to get the White House to recognize esports as a real sport and therefore grant visas to players playing esports in the United States of America. Now, you may ask, as Yanko once did to me a long time ago, what good is a petition? Well, if it's signed by enough people, I think it's 100,000, it is forced to go to the House for legislation, and therefore it must be brought to the attention of the lawmakers in the U.S. Sign the goddamn petition. We're going to take a break. When we come back, it's going to be CLG versus Liquid in our third and final North American division Counter-Strike matchup on ECS.